Okay, here I am again making set pieces for money for the buggy and the Baja project. I'm making Into the Woods, the musical. I had to make some birds. There's the stencils and the birds I sketched out. I made one pattern, but I glued the wings on differently, so it kind of looked like different birds. But I had to do a birds, a cow, and a harp. Here I am working on the cow, sketching it out. Transfer the pattern to the foam, cut the foam out and glue it up. There's the harp in the background and the birds. At this point, it's all starting to come together. Here's some scroll work that's going to go on the harp. I got one of the birds. I started carving a little bit to get some shape to it, to see what it's going to look like. There's a scroll work on the harp. Got that going. The birds, the wings are glued, but I haven't started carving them yet. Pretty much have the cow done at this point. At this point, I was starting to think I was done with the project. I just had the birds left to do. And I learned I made a mistake. I didn't really make a mistake. There was a misunderstanding between me and the person that I was working on. And at this point, I was feeling pretty excited about being done with the project. And it looked pretty good, but I would soon learn that I didn't ask enough questions. And I wasn't quite finished with the project like I thought I was. All right, at this point, what I thought I was going to be filming was me finishing this project. This is a cow from Into the Woods. He's supposed to be an old cow. He's supposed to be really skinny and starving. So I made the cow, a harp, and some doves. And this is what the backside of the cow looks like. This is the wood to support it. The legs are just foam to make it strong so it doesn't break. Unfortunately, unknown to me at the time, when I did this project, I thought this cow was just seen from this side on the stage. All the reference pictures that I was given and all the research that I did only showed the cow from this side. So I made the mistake of assuming that the cow only came on stage left or right, whichever it is, and it rolled on off. But it turns out this cow needed to be double-sided. So I've got to come over here in the backside, which would have just normally just been black because I thought it would have been away from it. So I've got to build all this out. I've got to cut some of this away, grind it away, redo the other side to match this side. I'm covering these supports up. So basically I'm doing twice as much work as I agreed to, but it was kind of my fault and the person that I'm doing it for. We've worked together for over 25 years. I've been doing these props for a long time, so it's kind of a bummer. Sometimes you're getting these things where things don't work out, but I'm just going to have to put my mind to it and give up another weekend. So they did agree to give me some more money. It's not going to be as much as I would have charged. Had I known this was a totally 3D piece, but I'm just going to have to salvage it. I'm not going to make the body really any thicker. It's 2, 4, 6, 8 inches thick. And it only gets seen from the front once. So I will make the head bigger, a little bit thicker, and try to get it 3D. But anyway, when you get in these kind of projects, it's just, you hope they go smoothly, but sometimes they don't. They also told me after the fact that the mouth, there needs to be a hole in the mouth where they can stuff things inside the mouth. So they need like a little hidden pocket on the inside in there where they can put stuff in and make him look like he's eating things, which also I didn't know until after the fact. So it's kind of a bummer. I mean, occasionally you get burned on these projects, but I'll get through it. But it'll still give me plenty of money to get the axles and CVs for the bug. You can see my transmission's not here, but I do have the mount for it. The transmission is coming this week, so that'll be the next video after this. So I will work on the cow a little bit longer, and the next videos you'll see is the cow being finished. Okay, now I'm starting to rework the cow. Here I am working on the cavity inside the mouth, and that's the center section of the head, and then the outside section of the head. I had to use pink because I was out of the green styrofoam, so it's the same, it's just a different color. So now I have the head thick enough where I can carve on it, and there I've got the cavity for the mouth. Okay, through the week I got all the new parts glued back on. I put a 1-inch piece here to cover some of the roughness there on the got the legs. I just had to put little filler pieces in, since this was supposed to be in the back, so I wasn't worried about it. But here, there's a little filler piece in there. So I'll carve that. I'm still going to have to put a 1-inch piece over all this to hide this piece of wood. But today I'm going to focus on the head. I've got the new ears glued on, extra pieces. Well, this is supposed to be this side of the head. Get around, there's enough thickness now I can make it 3D. They wanted the mouth functional, so you can stick your hand in there and hide some things, some props. So basically though, I have to kind of pull this eye over into this. Now that it's 3D, this will get carved kind of over into this direction. It's still in the right place, it's just got to come over into it. The nose will probably completely change. It'll be close, but it'll probably completely go away. So I'm going to focus on trying to get the head done today. Maybe I get the whole thing done. We'll just see how it goes. But anyway, so it's another weekend not working on the bug or the Baja, but you got to do what you got to do to make money. But I think today's Saturday. I should have my transmission tomorrow. I think he said it'll be done by the end of the week. So he's probably painting it today, because we have a 70 degree day today. So he paints them for you too. So hopefully tomorrow afternoon in the evening, I'll be picking up my transmission so we can start some Baja videos. The first phase of working on this, I take this little grater here and I just kind of soften the edges. So I'll just keep doing that, and that starts putting the edges on it, and like places like here where it sticks up, kind of just do the same thing. Just grind it down till it's the same across there. Get rid of that. That's basically what I do. I do that, and once I get past this point and get it down, then I move into sandpaper. So I'm gonna start shaping, get some basic shape to the head now, and then I'll come back to it. From here on out, I just keep continuing to work the head. I got the eyes starting to turn over, and basically I got the head the way I want it at this point. It's 3D enough. It's not perfectly 3D, but it'll work for the project.
A short survey, and you could win a month of gloriously uninterrupted music with Spotify Premium. That means you can enjoy all your favorite artists ad-free. Sound good? Then all you need to...
Okay, at this point, everything's carved and done, and I'm just starting to prep it for paint. I take caulk and fill all the screw holes and cracks. And if you use a Sharpie on foam, Sharpie will always bleed through the paint, so you have to cover that usually with caulk to get it off. There's my hand, my fist inside the horse's mouth to show the depth of it. But like I say, when I zoom in, you can see the little places of caulk on it, but it's ready to paint. One day in the future, I know I skim through a lot of these videos because I just do these for money, so I'm not trying to film a lot of them, but in the future, one day I'll film the whole process of me carving it with the sandpaper and do more depth and more with the painting and everything. But like I say, I kind of rush through these. I treat them like work, basically, so I'm not really trying to make a video out of them. Really, I just do it to share them. But in the future, I'll make a whole video and go into more detail for anyone that wants to see it. But everything got a base coat of white, and this cow's name is Milky White, so he's mostly white, so I didn't have to do a lot of painting on him. I basically just added a little bit of gray to him.
There's the doves. Yeah, they were pretty simple. I kept the cow pretty, almost like an albino. I didn't want to put a lot of dark colors on him because, again, he's supposed to be an all-white cow. So I kept it kind of cartoony, a little bit too, kind of like Disney-like. I didn't want it to be too sad. I mean, he's a skinny cow and he dies during the play, so I didn't want him to be too depressing. And the harp was actually hard to paint. It was actually hard to get the gold. I've got four or five coats of different paint on that harp to get it to look like gold. It was a pain in the ass, honestly, but eventually got it. And here's the cow outside in its natural habitat. So it worked out. I'm glad it's done. So we'll be on to the next video. Will be the transmission. So look forward to getting back on the buggy and the Baja. Like I say, I want to do an in-depth video on the transmission, what I bought, what went into it, and what it cost and everything. I'll be transparent about all of it and let you know what I got. But anyway, here's this project. The outside light's a little harsh on the gray on the cow there, the shading. Indoors, it blends in a lot better, but outside with the harsh light, you can see kind of dark lines on it. But all in all, it'll work perfectly for the play. I got it delivered yesterday and they loved it, so it worked out. So thanks again for watching the videos, and I'll see you on the next one. Thanks a lot. See you.